Anyway, the next match was Dr. Britt Baker with Reba versus Layla Hirsch, and I invoked the tooth and nail rule, which, as everyone will remember, since the tooth and nail match at Britt Baker's dentist office against the big swole that was the cinematic stinker that was not only the most embarrassing, phony, hokey thing that was ever done in wrestling, but it was actually shot so amateurishly and looked so low rent that we invoked a rule that nobody that was involved in any of it, we would ever watch any of their matches ever again. So Britt Baker, and I miss Reba. I liked seeing Reba. She was doing a good job, but we didn't watch this.
I watched it.
You watched it? I thought the tooth and nail rule.
You have a tooth and nail rule. I don't blame Britt Baker for Tony Khan.
I blame her for not fucking saying, I will quit if you make me do this.
Yeah, I don't blame her for that.
It's an affront to the wrestling industry.
She doesn't know anything about the history of the wrestling industry.
Hey, if
she's happy to be there.
If you're on television and you're not smart enough to figure out when you're doing something really rotten on television, and or if you're in the wrestling business and you've not been trained properly enough that you didn't know that that was offensive to the entire wrestling industry, then you don't need to be on TV or in wrestling.
How old is Britt Baker?
I have no idea.
What would you guess? Maybe 27, maybe?
25, 26, 27, somewhere around there.
So when if she was watching wrestling as a kid, think about
there
what
wasn't
she,
anything as bad on wrestling television as the tooth and nail match 5 years ago.
There was a lot of really bad shit and a lot of really stupid shit on Raw for years, going back to the Russo era. So I can't, again, I don't blame her. I blame Tony Khan. I blame whether it was Jerry Lynn or whoever else was the agent. I blame them.
I believe that Jerry Lynn was told, well, see if you can get something out of this, but it wasn't his idea.
But again, same thing with Britt Baker. I don't blame Britt Baker for that. Now, Big Swole is one of the worst wrestlers of all time. I will never not watch a Big Swole match because she's so bad that I need to see how bad it's going to be. I have to be honest about that. And this match, I watched it because I don't blame Britt Baker. And I got to say, she looked pretty good. And then the match was an all right match. And they had a big pull apart at the end with her and Thunder Rosa. And I like the idea that Britt Baker, who is not exactly proficient yet in the ring, but has a lot of potential and is a good personality. I like the idea of putting her with Thunder Rosa, who actually is really good in the ring. I watched it. I thought it was all right. It was an all right segment.
Well, remember, I was enjoying after that first heel interview that they did, where poor Britt was sent out to twist in the wind. She started doing those heel promos. We were liking it. She was entertaining. We said, okay, if they're not going to make her the top baby face because she's a professional dentist and a good-looking, you know, put-together young lady, professional and intelligent and educated and all that stuff, well, then they can make her a bitch heel. And she was doing that well. And then the tooth and nail thing came up, and I'll never watch any of those people ever again. I've never been so disgusted with something was actually aired that looked like that.
Oh, yeah, you've been disgusted with other things, too.
From any perspective, the tooth and nail thing was worse than the football field fuckery or all that stupid shit that Matt Hardy did where they shot fireworks at each other's crotches, because at least there was some star power in those things. And
I don't agree.
It was shot well, or not well.
I think the Matt Hardy stuff is much worse.
Anyway,